This Veterans Day, we honor our veterans differently than previous years. This year, there will be no parades or other large gatherings, but we still honor those who have sacrificed the most for our way of life. It has been a tough year for all of us as a nation. We celebrate Veterans Day on November 11th. This is the day that the fighting in the Great War ended with an armistice signed in France in 1918. We remember those who sacrificed their lives for us, for Europe, and a way of life on both continents to uphold freedom and democracy. But fighting this war was not the only thing our veterans faced. They came home, victorious and jubilant, but they also brought the Spanish flu with them to their families and loved ones. Across the nation, service members who had survived the horrors of World War I were dying, and little was known about the virus or how to stop it. During the pandemic, there were an estimated 500 million infected worldwide, 50 million of who died, with nearly 700,000 deaths in the United States alone. Of that number, the influenza took 43,000 U.S. service members. But I don't intend to compare numbers then versus now. I just want you to think about how those veterans at that time survived trench warfare and then returned home and continued the fight against the Spanish flu. Like in 1918, we will triumph over this virus while we continue to protect the nation, as we always do. And we will make the generations that came before us and those who come after us proud. As service members, Army, Navy, Air Force, Marines, and Coast Guard, we're representatives of American society. We're your fellow citizens relied upon to protect America's freedom. Just look at the National Guardsmen manning COVID testing sites or helping feed thousands in need. Think of the service members who helped fight the wildfires across the western United States. Remember those 165,000 U.S. military personnel who are currently deployed in 150 countries. We turn to our veteran role models to mirror their selfless service, heroism, sacrifice, and patriotism. Today, we stand on the shoulders of these giants to succeed. On this day, we recognize all veterans who have served, including those that have fought in our nation's wars, World War I, World War II, Korea, Vietnam, Desert Shield, Desert Storm, Iraq, and Afghanistan. All veterans share the same blood, the same sacrifice. Whether they fought the Taliban in Afghanistan, Ebola in West Africa, or the Viet Cong in the jungles of Vietnam, they forever share the same bond. It is the same bond earned by our pre-armistice forefathers who fought in the American Revolution and Spanish-American War. Whenever America or her interests have been threatened, men and women from across this great nation have risen to her defense and raised their right hand to solemnly swear to support and defend the Constitution of the United States. Veterans are part of a uniquely American collective and are less than 0.5% of the U.S. population who answered the call. Many veterans have come home recovering from wounds, both seen and unseen, with which they will live for the rest of their lives. The effort of the American veteran to come to terms with the loss of fellow service members and haunting memories, to readjust to life back home, and to recover from lingering physical or psychological wounds is one we share together. We must be there for one another. Today, I ask you to reach out to family members and friends. Over the phone or virtually may be the best method. Thank a veteran for their service. Ask a veteran their story. Ask them why they joined and what they value the most. The reward of that interaction will be priceless for all of you. Thanks to you for what you do and will do for our nation. I and the entire DLI and Presidio Monterrey leadership wish you a safe and happy Veterans Day.